I was about to head into town to share news of your survival. You should go there and let them know yourself. It's just up the path. On your way, then.
わあわあわあ。It is a bloom, Sakroth.
I did.
I might, but only if you meet the right requirements. My only requirement is that you be my friend. One of my best friends, to be exact.Don't be hasty. We've only just met. There are some things I need to know about you first. Is your favourite colour orange or yellow? I see. Now, if you had to choose between eating slugs or cakes, which would you eat?Maybe I can make you some slug cakes? This next one will be tricky. If you saw a frog stranded all alone on a lily pad, what would you do? That is rather heartless. Don't let the frogs hear you speaking that way. I feel as if I have come to know you very well.Would you agree that we can be friends now? Oh, wondrous! Here, now we can sit on rafts together. You'll need some twine to keep it all together. I don't know how to make that, but Ona has a lot of it. You also need wax, and that's very hard to find. Sometimes there's stale candles. But don't tell Ona!
What a lovely sandy beach you've painted. Would you be willing to give it away for the opportunity to learn? This is splendid. It will be the prized piece of my sitting room. Now, here's how to make twine. Mind the plants underfoot.
I saw some birds flying around a few nights ago. They were so graceful. I especially liked the ones that do this. Ooh, ooh. What a fun way to talk. Ooh. Fancy, fancy city folk. But they do buy my pots.Bye now.
I'm pretty busy if you couldn't tell. I've got all these trails to maintain, tourists to wrangle, animals to nurture, plants to relocate. I'll be lucky if I ever get to take another break in my whole life. Yeah, it is. At least someone understands what goes into making a national park. I'm just really stressed today. Oh, and I've also got to go rescue a stupid water fox, as if I didn't already have enough work to do.
They're aquatic rodents, essentially. Like to live in watery caves. People think they're adorable, but in my opinion, they're just wretched. My responsibility here is maintaining the trails. That's why I was hired. These water foxes are a huge thorn in my paw, and they distract me from my real tasks. My partner was the one who took care of the water foxes. Now he's gone, and I have no idea to handle these animals. I've been trying to trap one all day. Tried every type of bait under the moon. He wanted to see the world! I don't blame him for that. But he could have at least left some instructions for taking care of these horrid animals. One of them mangled his foot, and I was trying to administer some salve before it gets infected. I've already wasted so much time trying to catch him. I really can't spend another day on this. I think it's officially a lost cause.
Yeah, he'll probably die. And his kits won't last long without him either. I guess it's sad, but the trails need maintenance.
I'm not really supposed to let visitors get so close to the wildlife, but I guess it doesn't matter at this point. The water foxes are living in a cave, not more than 100 paces from me. City folk. It's like they've never seen a trail before, always trampling through the foliage like animals. You managed to trap him. I heard the shrieks all the way above ground. I need to administer the salve.
I guess I should thank you. I'm afraid to give up on this damned water fox. Listen, it's pretty clear that you're a nature lover. I don't know how you managed to catch that animal, but I do appreciate it. Let me show you how to make a snug tent. Should be useful for someone like you, roaming the country and all. It will give you a place to relax if you need to kill time, and shelter if you find night sneaking up on you.